Tonight begins the third night of Hanukkah. First, we do Havdalah, and then we light the Hanukkah candles. Please join me in the lighting of the Hanukkah candles.
Shalom. Chanukah is the festival when Jews celebrate their victory in the fight for religious freedom more than 2,000 years ago. Tragically, that fight is no less important today, and not only for Jews, but for people of all faiths. The Chanukah story is simple enough. Around 165 BCE, Antiochus IV, ruler of the Syrian branch of the Alexandrian Empire, began to impose Greek culture on the Jews of the land of Israel. Funds were diverted from the temple to public games and drama competitions. A statue of Zeus was erected in Jerusalem. Jewish religious rituals such as circumcision and the observance of Shabbat were banned. Those who kept those observances were persecuted. It was a great crisis moment in Jewish history. There was a real possibility that Judaism, the world's first monotheistic faith, would be erased. Jewish pietists rose in rebellion led by Matityahu of Modi'in and his son Judah Maccabee. They began the fight for liberty. Outnumbered, they suffered heavy initial casualties, but within 3 years, they had secured a momentous victory. Jerusalem was restored to Jewish hands. The temple was rededicated. The celebrations lasted for 8 days. Chanukah, which means dedication, was established as a festival to perpetuate the memory of those days and of those triumphs. Almost 22 centuries have passed since then. Yet today, religious liberty, as enshrined in Article 18 in the United Nations Universal Declaration of Human Rights, is at risk in many parts of the world. ADL's annual top moments of hate highlight the degree to which this is a phenomenon that afflicts the world. Globalization means that conflict anywhere can be exported everywhere and attacks continue to multiply around the world. Ours is not an era of peace, but an age of proliferating tribal, ethnic, and religious clashes. Region after region has been reduced to what Thomas Hobbes called the war of every man against every man, in which life becomes solitary, poor, nasty, brutish, and short. I'm indebted to Rabbi Lord Jonathan Sacks, Zichrono Livracha, who served as chief rabbi of the United Kingdom and the Commonwealth between 1991 and 2013, and who died just earlier this year. He called attention for me to this article. In the article, he cites Oxford philosopher John Plamenatz, who noted that religious freedom was born in Europe in the 17th century after a devastating series of religious wars. All it took was a shift from the belief that faith is the most important thing, therefore everyone should honor the one true faith, to the belief that faith is the most important thing, therefore everyone should be free to honor his or her own faith. People of all faiths were now guaranteed that whichever religion was dominant, each person would be free to obey the call of their own conscience. Plamenatz's striking conclusion was that liberty of conscience was born not of indifference, not of skepticism, not of mere open-mindedness, but of faith. The very fact that my religion is important to me allows me to understand that your quite different religion is no less important to you. Real faith, true belief, makes me less self-centered and less self-absorbed. Real and true faith moves me beyond selfish needs and desires and focuses me on how I can benefit others and society. Chanukah reminds us that people will fight for religious freedom, and the attempt to deprive them of it will always end in failure. Chanukah reminds us that centuries of bloodshed have happened before people were prepared to acknowledge this very simple truth. Chanukah reminds us that this is a victory that, unfortunately, has to be won anew in every generation. As the lights of the Chanukiah shine in remembrance of the heroism of our Maccabee ancestors, we remind and challenge ourselves through the words of a song we sing on the festival. Mi yimalel gvurot Yisrael, otan mi yimneh. Who can retell the things that befell us? Who can count them? Hein bechol dor yakum hagibor goel ha'am. In every age, a hero arises to engineer our redemption. Shma bayamim ha'hem bazman hazeh, Maccabi Moshiach ufodeh, uvyamenu kol am Yisrael, yitached yakum v'yigael. But now, in our day, all Israel, indeed all people of faith, must arise as one, and thus united, bring redemption to each other and to the world, in fulfillment of the ancient dream and the flickering lights of Chanukah. Chag Orim Sameach.
Have a little cradle, I made it out of clay. And when it's dry and ready, the cradle I shall play. Oh, cradle, 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 I made it out of clay. Oh, cradle, 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 my cradle I shall play. It has a lovely body, with legs so short and thin. And when it is all tired, it drops and then I weep. Oh, cradle, 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 with legs so short and thin. It loves to dance and spin. A happy game of cradle, come play and let's begin. Oh, cradle, 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 it loves to dance and spin. Oh, cradle, 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 come play and let's begin.
נפשנו בגיל ובשמחה ממלאים את ליבנו לילה ויום סביב עולנו נזור סופניות נוחה ומאות היינו הביטו מרחם כל אביב גם הנפסים ויאב
I am in my heart.